What is going on, world? Welcome to Mixclusives here on Mix. Who is ready for David Guetta? He's going to be in the house today. Share this stream wherever you are at. If you are on Kumu, YouTube, Twitch, share the stream right now. If you're not following us, follow us right now. Big purple button on Kumu that says follow. Follow that button or press that button if you are on YouTube and Twitch. Subscribe. Amazing DJs, artists coming your way. Like today, David Guetta is going to be here. He's going to be talking about his brand new single. Plus, he has a secret he's going to be talking about during the show. So, follow us right now, everybody. We're going to start our live stream very soon. Hang tight. This is Mixclusives with David Guetta here on Mix.
You ready to get on a trip with me? Rave mode to Moland.
Oh, Hey guys, Danny Bay here from Manila's Wave 89.1, Mix Radio on Dash, and Mix Global on Kumu and Twitch. And with me, I have the legendary David Guetta. How are you doing?
I'm good, man. Nice to meet you.
Yes, nice to meet you. I'm very honored to be in your presence right now. It's a very, very huge honor. Thank you so much for your time. And I know you're here to promote your new epic track with Sia titled Let's Love. And before we go in depth with that song, allow me to kind of backtrack a bit for your Philippine fans, if that's okay with you.
Sure.
All right. So back in 2013, you showed love for the Philippines with a campaign with the UN after the Typhoon Haiyan hit. And it raised a lot of funds and helped to rebuild and aid the country. So, you know, you always seem to have some type of involvement with things of this nature. So what I wanted to ask you is, what advice would you give to those wanting to help with charity and stuff like that? And don't know what to do or how to do it? Like, where would you lead them or things like that?
Well, every time I did something, you know, I don't consider myself like a specialist. So whether it was for the Philippines or when I just did those events for the COVID, you know, in Miami and New York City, what I can do is bring what I can do, which is being an entertainer and, you know, giving money myself and asking money to people. But then I led the rest to people that are professionals. So I think everybody should do what they can on their own levels, you know, like right. If you have an ability, it could be being an artist or it could be being a really good with a, I don't know, organization and helping organization for a moment, or it could be being on the ground. Like, you know, we with what I did in Miami, we collected millions of meals that yes. we could distribute to people. I didn't give the meals myself, you know, but my work was important, and the work of the people that were distributing the meals were as much as important. I'm saying, like, if people want to help, of course you can always help, you know?
Right, exactly. And I brought that up because you've been doing these live streaming events called United at Home. What sparked the idea? Is it just the same thing? You just want to help in your own way with your platform? You know, a lot of people.
Yeah, well, you know, it was such a crazy moment. Like, first, I was missing being on stage. I have to be honest. It was all generosity. I also wanted to have fun.
For sure.
And there was like a few shows. You know, DJs playing in the bedrooms, but I felt like it was boring. And. And, you know, I was like, come on, we are entertainers. Like, what are we talking? These are big names, you know? Right. So let's try to do something big with a real production, something that is exciting to watch. And we find the idea of Miami at the Icon Towers. And what was cool is that I had people on the balconies. So it gave me the feeling of having a real crowd, even though it was not in front of me.
Right.
And then it was at a moment that people had nothing to do. So it's crazy because it was only online and mm-hmm. we did 50 million views, which is
right
crazy on my socials. I mean, to do 50 million views on social media is unbelievable.
Amazing.
That would be like a major, major American TV show. You know, it's huge. Right.
It's huge. So, it's a Guinness Book of World Record. It's a record.
Oh, yeah. Well, by the way, yeah.
it's a record.
Yeah, it's true. But what happened, it was just a very specific moment in time where people had nothing to do. So everybody was watching it and we raised a lot of money. Thanks to that, I was really, really proud. And also, you know, it felt good to play again, you know?
Exactly. I can imagine. I know you're itching to get into a real tour and be in front of real people soon. Hopefully when this all passes, that will happen. But one thing I wanted to mention, I'm going way back with this one. You know, in the Philippines, we support our own. And when you work with the Black Eyed Peas in 2009 with I Got a Feeling, up until now, because Apple from the group is Filipino, of course. And although it's more than 10 years ago, that song still has a lot of power today and it still gets such a big reaction. So, you know, can you talk about how that song was such a impactful force and how it still means so much to you to this day?
It's the biggest song that I produced in my life.
Right.
And actually, it's also the song that is behind my idea of doing Let's Love with Sia. Why? Because we made I Got a Feeling when it was the peak of the financial crisis. It was terrible. People were losing their jobs, were losing their houses. It was really a terrible situation. And what did we do? We didn't do a depressing song like, oh, life sucks, you know? No, we did a celebration of life song. Right. And I think this helped people at that time. That's why it was so heavily played. And in the same way, the record that I'm coming with now in the middle of a big crisis is, right, is Let's Love. And it's a celebration of life. It's about going through this together and not against each other. And I believe in this. I believe in positive answers to anything.
Exactly. And, you know, music in general is like an escape for any reason, whether, you know, you're going through any type of situation. And the music you make is always something that's impactful out there. So how did linking up with Sia happen? How did you decide, or how did that work out, you guys working together on this track?
Well, you know, we've been working so many times together. So it's she's like, if I'm thinking, oh, let's write a fantastic, inspiring song, I think of her automatically.
Right, so, right.
I didn't text anyone else.
Oh, okay.
I wanted to do that song. I texted her directly, you know?
Right away.
She's the first artist I called. And she's a genius, you know? Like, I wrote her this little text message, you know, let's make a happy song about going through this together and not against each other. Sent her a piano chord progression. Mm-hmm. 24 hours later, I had the entire song. You know, wow. This is crazy.
Works fast. Works fast.
So, you know, like, of course, after the production is a lot of work, you know, but
right,
but the foundation of the song was there. And also, like, I remember when we started to work together at the time of Titanium and all this, mm-hmm, we would write 3-4 songs a day. She's a machine. It's insane.
Wow, I can imagine. And, you know, the song is so amazing. What is the one thing, if you were to tell your fans or hope for your fans to get out of after listening to the song, what's the goal? Like, what do you want them to feel from it after listening to the track for the first time, especially?
I just want them to feel good and to feel like they're part of the world, they're part of the universe, that we are not individuals. We are not separated nations or separated races in front of this problem. We are one, you know? So let's go through this together. Let's make the best out of the situation, but let's not fight between us. Let's not, you know, abandon our brothers,
right,
human beings, you know, on the side of the road.
Definitely, definitely. So everyone watching right now, for sure, you need to go stream it. If you haven't heard it yet, listen to it and share it with all your friends. But I have just one or two more questions. In 2017, you came to Manila, and I actually went to the show. It was amazing, and we all love you here in the Philippines. So can you give a message to your fans out here in the Philippines?
Well, you know, not only the Philippines are amazing, not only I have my friend from the Black Eyed Peas that is from here, but yes, also I'm gonna tell you a secret. Is
sure,
that with my girlfriend, we have a secret island. And when we want to hide from the world and be the most romantic possible,
what?
We go to the Filipinos.
Oh my God, that is amazing.
And this is our favorite place in the world.
Wow, that is an amazing fact about you. That is crazy. And I'm so glad that you enjoy the country. And you know what? The Philippines has much love for you. Mr. David Guetta, it was an honor to meet you. And like I said earlier, everybody tuning in right now, please support his new track with Sia. Of course, it's called Let's Love. And once again, David, thank you so much.
Thank you, my friend. Bye.
All right. God bless. Peace.
Bye.
Slide you.
coming on Mixed Live Daily on Twitch. Ali Gatti on Exclusives. David Guetta on Exclusives. Cedrice on Mixtape Live Concert. DJ Qbert on Mixology. Phineas on Exclusives. Angel on Heavy Rotation. Tracy Cruz on Heavy Rotation Live. Clean Bandit on Exclusives. Fresh artists and music first from around the world. Balance of Fun, watch the end.
Shout out to the UN Foundation that is also helping us so much. 340,000 dollars. And yes, we on Times Square. Show your face on Times Square. Go to Zoom and go to davidguetta.com/donate.
Thank you.
Premier League Soccer and Heineken are matching every donation. Thank you so much. We're almost at $350,000.
There's too small time to turn.
What's up, live from New York City? Comment ça va les Français? Comment estamos, gente latina? I see some family partying at home with their kids, with their dogs. Today is the day to forget about everything. To feel joy and happiness. This is why we're here. But we also want to help. Please donate. Let's go.
On Tuesday.
$80,000. Thank you so, so much. We are at $350,000. And for Perfection Snacks, just get $80,000. Thank you, everybody. Thank you so much.
If you're gonna go, yeah, if you're gonna go, yeah, if you're gonna kill. 20 days. I've been going round and round, street city things. Now you say it's wrong, it now, not right now. Then you make me walk and play. Let it be known. Touching your teeth and be telling me no. But this time I need to feel you right. I don't want to know, right. Just lose control, right. Right, my soul, right. Make me feel you right. Turn around, tell me no, right. From head to toe, right. So
this is 100% Detroit City. This is such an incredible moment. The Empire State Building is flashing behind us. This is for us, this is for you. This is for all the people helping in the hospitals. Our heroes. So please keep giving for them. I'll see you, Miami!
Exclusives. David Guetta on exclusives. Cedrice on mixtape live concert. DJ Qbert on mixology. Phineas on exclusives. Angel on heavy rotation. Tracy Cruz on Heavy Rotation Live. Clean Bandit on exclusives. Fresh artists and music first from around the world.
Hey guys, Danny Bay here from Manila's Wave 89.1, Mix Radio on Dash, and Mix Global on Kumu and Twitch. And with me, I have the legendary David Guetta. How are you doing?
I'm good, man. Nice to meet you.
Yes, nice to meet you. I'm very honored to be in your presence right now. It's a very, very huge honor. Thank you so much for your time. And I know you're here to promote your new epic track with Sia titled Let's Love. And before we go in depth with that song, allow me to kind of backtrack a bit for your Philippine fans, if that's okay with you.
Sure.
All right. So back in 2013, you showed love for the Philippines with a campaign with the UN after the Typhoon Haiyan hit. And it raised a lot of funds and helped to rebuild and aid the country. So, you know, you always seem to have some type of involvement with things of this nature. So what I wanted to ask you is, what advice would you give to those wanting to help with charity and stuff like that and don't know what to do or how to do it? Like, where would you lead them or things like that?
Well, every time I did something, you know, I don't consider myself like a specialist. So whether it was for the Philippines or when I just did those events for the COVID, you know, in Miami and New York City, what I can do is bring what I can do, which is being an entertainer and, you know, giving money myself and asking money to people. But then I let the rest to people that are professionals. So I think everybody should do what they can on their own levels, you know, like right. If you have an ability, it could be being an artist or it could be being a really good with a, I don't know, organization and helping organization for a moment, or it could be being on the ground. Like, you know, we with what I did in Miami, we collected millions of meals that we could distribute to people. I didn't give the meals myself, you know, but my work was important, and the work of the people that were distributing the meals were as much as important. I'm saying, like, if people want to help, of course you can always help, you know?
Right, exactly. And I brought that up because you've been doing these live streaming events called United at Home. What sparked the idea? Is it just the same thing? You just want to help in your own way with your platform? You know, a lot of people.
Yeah, well, you know, it was such a crazy moment. Like, first, I was missing being on stage. I have to be honest. It was all generosity. I also wanted to have fun.
For sure, for sure.
And there was like a few shows, you know, DJs playing in the bedrooms, but I felt like it was boring. And and you know, I was like, come on, we are entertainers, like, what are we talking? These are big names, you know. Right. So let's try to do something big with a real production, something that is exciting to watch. And we find the idea of Miami at the Icon Towers. And what was cool is that I had people on the balconies. So it gave me the feeling of having a real crowd, even though it was not in front of me.
Right.
And then it was at a moment that people had nothing to do. So it's crazy because it was only online and we did 50 million views, which is
right
crazy on my socials. I mean, to do 50 million views on social media is unbelievable.
Amazing.
That would be like a major, major American TV show. You know, it's huge. Right.
It's huge. So, it's a Guinness Book of World Record. It's a record.
Oh, yeah. Well, by the way, yeah.
it's a record.
Yeah, it's true. It's true. But what happened, it was just a very specific moment in time where people had nothing to do. So everybody was watching it, and we raised a lot of money thanks to that. I was really, really proud. And also, you know, it felt good to play again, you know?
Exactly. I can imagine. I know you're itching to get into a real tour and be in front of real people soon. Hopefully when this all passes, that will happen. But one thing I wanted to mention, I'm going way back with this one. You know, in the Philippines, we support our own. And when you work with the Black Eyed Peas in 2009 with I Got a Feeling, up until now, because Apple from the group is Filipino, of course. And although it's more than 10 years ago, that song still has a lot of power today and it still gets such a big reaction. So, you know, can you talk about how that song was such a impactful force and how it still means so much to you to this day?
It's the biggest song that I produced in my life.
Right.
And actually, it's also the song that is behind my idea of doing Let's Love with Sia. Why? Because we met, I Got a Feeling, when it was the peak of a financial crisis. It was terrible, terrible. Right. People were losing their jobs, were losing their houses. It was really a terrible situation. And what did we do? We didn't do a depressing song like, oh, life sucks, you know? No, we did a celebration of life song. Right. And I think this helped people at that time. That's why it was so heavily played. And in the same way, the record that I'm coming with now in the middle of a big crisis is right. Let's Love. And it's a celebration of life. It's about going through this together and not against each other. And I believe in this. I believe in positive answers to anything.
Exactly. And, you know, music in general is like an escape for any reason, whether, you know, you're going through any type of situation. And the music you make is always something that's impactful out there. So how did linking up with Sia happen? How did you decide, or how did that work out, you guys working together on this track?
Well, you know, we've been working so many times together. So it's she's like, if I'm thinking, oh, let's write a fantastic, inspiring song, I think of her automatically.
Right,
so,
right.
I didn't text anyone else.
I
wanted to do that song, and I texted her directly, you know?
Right away.
She's the first artist I called, and she's a genius, you know? Like, I wrote her this little text message, you know, let's make a happy song about going through this together and not against each other. Sent her a piano chord progression. Mm-hmm. 24 hours later, I had the entire song. You know,
wow.
This is crazy.
Works yeah. fast. Works fast.
So, you know, like, of course, after the production is a lot of work, you know, but
right.
but the foundation of the song was there. And also, like, I remember when we started to work together at the time of Titanium and all this, mm-hmm. we would write 3-4 songs a day.
I see.
She's a machine. It's insane.
Wow, I can imagine. And, you know, the song is so amazing. What is the one thing, if you were to tell your fans or hope for your fans to get out of after listening to the song, what's the goal? Like, what do you want them to feel from it after listening to the track for the first time, especially?
I just want them to feel good and to feel like they're part of the world, they're part of the universe, that we are not individuals. We are not separated nations or separated races in front of this problem. We are one, you know? So let's go through this together. Let's make the best out of the situation, but let's not fight between us. Let's not, you know, abandon our brothers,
right.
Human beings, you know, on the side of the road.
Definitely, definitely. So everyone watching right now, for sure, you need to go stream it. If you haven't heard it yet, listen to it and share it with all your friends. But I have just one or two more questions. In 2017, you came to Manila, and I actually went to the show. It was amazing, and we all love you here in the Philippines. So can you give a message to your fans out here in the Philippines?
Well, you know, not only the Philippines are amazing, not only I have my friend from the Black Eyed Peas that is from here, but yes. Also I'm gonna tell you a secret. Is
sure.
that with my girlfriend, we have a secret island. And when we want to hide from the world and be the most romantic possible,
what?
We go to the Filipinos.
Oh my God, that is
I
so
promise.
Amazing.
And this is our favorite place in the world.
Wow, that is an amazing fact about you. That is crazy. And I'm so glad that you enjoy the country. And you know what? The Philippines has much love for you. Mr. David Guetta, it was an honor to meet you. And like I said earlier, everybody tuning in right now, please support his new track with Sia. Of course, it's called Let's Love. And once again, David, thank you so much.
Thank you, my friend. Bye.
All right. God bless. Peace.
Bye.
Slide you.
upcoming on Mixed Live Daily on Twitch. Ali Gatti on Exclusives. David Guetta on Exclusives. Cedriz on Mixtape Live Concert. DJ Qbert on Mixology. Phineas on Exclusives. Angel on Heavy Rotation. Tracy Cruz on Heavy Rotation Live. Clean Bandit on Exclusives. Fresh artists and music first from around the world. Balance of Fun, watch the end.
Introduction, you hear it, you know why. No, it's dive into an era with the beats of lo-fi. Put my face in the book, cause my people are profile. Erase from the books, and my people are told by. Sky's the limit, go fly, Cali, creamy, go high. I mean,
yeah, I just want the money, I'ma count it up, stack it to the sky. Ain't nine different city, rockin' with my bros, chasing the sun.
People gon' get in the way, dodge them like a bee, smoke the other way. New day, new mindset. The lights say I got a little juice left. People, when
I just wanna love ya, be more than friends tonight. I just wanna love ya, be more than friends tonight. Baby, let's get in something. Let me know you feel the vibe. I just wanna love ya, be more than friends tonight.
All right, you guys, once again, thank you to David Guetta for being in the house today on Mixclusives here on Mix. And for Danny Boy, amazing interview. Remember what he said? He has a secret island in the Philippines. And that is amazing that he loves the Philippines that much, that he loves to spend a lot of his time there. So big ups to David Guetta for supporting our country and to showing a lot of love to the Filipino people out there. So, all right, you guys just saw that promo. Coming up next, Heavy Rotation, we have a ticket giveaway for the Joy Ruckus Club Virtual Music Festival, and I have three of the artists performing there that we feature on Heavy Rotation: Russ Cassone from San Jose, Reckless Escapade and Marissa Lynn from Malaysia, and we have Rocky Sandoval from Tacoma, Washington. So here's what we're going to do. We're going to switch things out. Make sure you come back in about 2 minutes. And you got a chance to win free tickets and some coins if you were on Kumu. And we're going to be probably doing some free subscriptions too on Twitch if you're not a subscriber yet. So let's do that right now. Here you go. Follow us on all platforms. And we're going to be right back.